Rupert Sheldrake, a great scientist in Cambridge, has written this book for you. Rupert Sheldrake's book, Dogs Which Know When the Owner Comes Home. Please read that book. Consciousness is a great thing. And everything is in consciousness. Everything is in your mind. In short, you see the world through your consciousness. That is called biocentrism. And there's a beautiful book written by a great scientist called Robert Lanza. Robert Lanza is professor of medicine in Washington. And this book is called Biocentrism. Please read that book, Biocentrism. So that, not that science doesn't know about it, but the materialistic science does not want to know about it. Because if you know about consciousness, then you can't do a lot of things. Screening, drugging, this, that, all kinds of things. So they don't want to know about it. So they are shutting their eyes. It's like an ostrich. Ostrich doesn't want to see you. So it digs its head in the sand. So scientists, the materialistic scientists who depend on money grant-giving organizations and depending on that and call it a science are the ones don't want to know about consciousness. That is why earlier on I said, sir, that I'm getting David Weber's professor of neurology in Mayo Clinic to come here to talk about his book, The Theory of Reality. The reality is something totally different from what you and I talk about science or medicine. So the reality is the future and consciousness is the future. And if you know your consciousness, you know a lot of things. And Sanskrit is the ideal language for that. Have you heard of the word gochara, gochara? You know, gochara in every language, in Hindi, in Malayalam, everybody goes gochara. But in Sanskrit, gochara has different meanings. Gochara, the path through which the cow walks, gochara. But gochara is consciousness. See, this is a great thing. We have all this. We have consciousness. Our sages have talked about it. Now we say in the thing, uncertainty principle, PQ is not equivalent to QP. Same photon can be at two places. When our people say Narada can be in two places at the same time, he said, hey, what foolish these Indians are. You know, they are folks in the forest. But they say a same photon can be in two places at the same time. So beautiful in Upanishad. Asi no vrajati duram, shayano jati sarvata. This is about the electron. What a fascinating thing. Has anybody seen an electron? No, but science gives Nobel Prize for that. 1907, Father J.J. Thomson in the Cavendish Institute in Cambridge gets the Nobel Prize for saying electrons are particles. Has he seen it? No. Then 30 years later, G.J. Thomson, his son, same director of the Cavendish Institute, he becomes after the father's death, and he says they are waves, he gets Nobel Prize. And Werner Heisenberg comes and says, oh, they are neither particles nor their uncertainty. He gets the Nobel Prize. Now, which science is correct? So ultimately, it is your consciousness, your biocentrism, your world, the view. Now, I see all of you. Suppose I close my eyes. I don't know if you are alive here or not. I don't know. So it is my perception. And Max Planck says, for a perception, there must be a perceiver. So you are a perceiver. And if you understand all these things in Indian scriptures, oh, it's a great thing. So consciousness is good, sir. Science doesn't accept. It doesn't matter. New science will come.
Hello, doctor. Can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
Hi. My question is regarding the cholesterol.
More the merrier. More the merrier. Don't worry. In French nursing homes, they found 90-year-old ladies in the nursing home having cholesterol of 800, 900 milligrams, and that's the reason why they are 90 years old. If you have 150, you will never see 90 years. Don't worry.
Okay. But my question is, like, which oil is good? Because they say, like, Gronet oil or any sunflower oil.
What a nice question. What a nice question. What a nice question. The only oil in the world which is good for human beings other than mother's milk is coconut oil. And if your cholesterol is high, please take a teaspoon of virgin coconut oil in the mouth every day and watch after 1 month your cholesterol will come down. But if you take any one of the anti-cholesterol drugs, they block the cholesterol production in the liver because your own liver produces liver. Liver is not foolish to produce cholesterol, which it doesn't require. I said why cholesterol is going up, I told you. You're seeing human tigers and run away from them. So make the tigers your friends, your cholesterol will come down. Did you understand that? Make your work your play,
make your work your wife your friend, and make your husband your friend, make your boss your friend, make your assistant your friend, and your cholesterol will come down. Done. Next.
Next Sir. Question, doctor. Can diabetes be reversed? And what is your opinion about the organic food mania these days?
What is it? What mania?
Organic food.
Life itself is mania. So organic food is good, but where do you get organic food? Not in the shop. You can do it in your own house. That's organic. Not in the, don't depend on the shop, because that's okay, another industry. Organic food is good. Diabetes, yes, can be, diabetes can be controlled, but not in everybody. Diabetes can be controlled and reversed. But we have plans not to control, because we tell you when you are a diabetic, you take wheat. Because wheat, gluten, damages the pancreas and keeps you a diabetic permanently. So we don't want to lose a client, do you? Supposing I am selling idlis, do you think I won't want less people to eat idlis? I want more people to eat idlis. Next.
Sir, hello. My question is regarding osteoarthritis.
What?
Osteoarthritis.
Osteoarthritis simply means your joint is aging. You ask yourself whether you're abusing your joint.
No, but we are seeing many middle-aged persons not able to walk, seen in wheelchairs, in airports and everywhere. So
you should have thought of it when you are young. Now I advise everybody in the young age to not to put on weight, because that puts extra strain on your knee joint. Our knee joint is like dog's knee joint. It is only a bone sitting on another bone. So more you damage it, you abuse your legs. What we have now shown is Indian dance, classical dance system is a prevention for osteoarthritis. I have introduced this in the aging institute in Canada. Two things, as age advances, two things go bad. One is joint, other is the breath. You know, your breath goes down. Supposing you say, oh, this is your maximum breathing capacity. I have seen a lady, 98-year-old lady, doing pranayama for 40 years, a European lady. She was the longest om thing the other day on the yoga day, 98 years. When all of us finished our om, she was still saying, oh. So, Indian pranayama, Indian classical music, alapana. These are the two things which keep you healthy as long as you live. Osteoarthritis is a simple disease. Don't take painkillers. They are real killers. Simple medicine, I'll tell you. If you have osteoarthritis, if not very bad, first thing is you take castor oil. Dip a cloth in castor oil, squeeze it, wrap it around the joint and give it steam. In 1 week, you will be able to walk. Steam, not hot water. The steam is the only thing that releases heat at 100 degrees centigrade after it touches the thing. And then in New York University Orthopedics Department, they use only this. And we have, of course, developed some electromagnetic energy devices which will correct your cartilages which have gone bad. Mrs. Pratibha Patil had it, Renuka Chaudhary had it, and so many people have it. And it's not a very big thing. But don't take painkillers. Folded hands, I request you, don't take painkillers. Next slide.
Doctor, I have two questions. My name is Sushilendra Nittur. First question is about the migraine. So I want migraine. How it come? What is the reason and what is the cure? Second question is, as per this medical science, the soul exists in the brain. That's what I heard from one of the doctor. But as per the spirituality and the Upanishads,
tell me,
soul exists in heart. So I want your comments, sir.
First question is about
migraine. Migraine.
Migraine or any other headache. You don't have a headache. You are a headache. Did you understand that?
Okay.
You don't have a neck ache. You are a pain in the neck. In short, either you are a misfit in your society or others are misfits in your company. So you all the time are worried. You stretch your forehead. Relax, young man, relax.
Actually, one of my colleagues having...
Wait. Okay. Tell him. I know. Yeah. You can always ask a question about your neighbor. Don't worry.
Yeah.
I will tell you. You just know how to meditate properly, your headache will go away. Okay. I'll give you a book if you don't believe me. The is written by a person, girl who should have got Nobel Prize, but her boss stole her data. Her name is Candace Pert. What's the name of the girl?
Candace Pert.
Candace Pert. She has written a book called Molecules of Emotion.
In one of the video clips, I came to know this from you.
You read that book?
Yeah. No, on the video clip you have told this. Sir.
Okay, you tell me. The girl says, don't reach for a tablet cupboard when you have a headache. Sit in a quiet place, meditate, elevate your consciousness to the level where your own body produces enough opioids to get rid of the pain.
Okay.
Next, now what is the next question?
Next question is, as per the medical science, soul exists in the brain. As per the spirituality or Upanishads, the soul exists in the heart. So, what is your comment and what is correct?
Mind is everywhere, in the heart, in the brain.
Soul,
the...
soul, not mind, soul.
Soul, 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 soul. I am not a Swamiji. To answer a question, I can answer that, but I don't want to answer because Swamijis are more authentic to answer the question. I must have the Kavi dress, then only I can answer that. But I can tell you about the soul. Don't worry about it now. It's too esoteric for you and me.